Blah.
You got it. She's always so composed, or so poised, so elegant and classy everywhere she goes. Just hope she can hold it together in there.
She's a tough cookie, Victoria, so I'm sure she'll be okay.
Good afternoon, Ed. It's nice to meet you.
Afternoon. So, Victoria, would you like to explain your business in a nutshell?
So, currently I'm running an online pick-and-mix company, but I'm hoping to use the investment to start kiosks.
OK. So, you set up the business following a five-year career working as a VIP flight attendant. How does that skill translate into the pick-and-mix industry?
I actually did plating of the first class food to make sure that it was up to the standard of the airline and deliver that to the customers.
I know, but it's not related to pick and mix, is it?
Yeah, no,
so,
I understand.
So it doesn't have any relevance. But then you go on to state there's a gap in the market, but I think there is absolutely no gap in the market for pick and mix. It's absolutely saturated.
It is definitely a saturated market, but with my well-presented boxes, that's where I found the gap in the market. And I think with the growth of the company in 6 months, I think that shows that people like the presentation of the boxes.
I know, but I think your best chance is keep the cottage industry, let it grow slowly.
I had a company that wanted to order 5,000 boxes off me, so they want them for the corporation industry.
You're coming back to exactly what I said. Let your cottage industry grow, and you know what? If it's no good, the airlines, they need good stewardesses at the moment.
Thank you.
Oh, she doesn't look happy.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, Vic, how did that go? Yeah.
I mean, she was savage.
Really?
At one point, she told me that I could get a job back at the airline.
What?
Whatever.
Why?
She said that my business was a cottage business, so, yeah.